In this video, we will look at the substring function for Teradata. The examples I provide will use ANSI syntax. My first line of code is commented out to show the syntax used for the substring function. The first argument in the function is the string expression itself, followed by the starting position using the from clause. The last argument is used to return the number of characters, or length of the string, and this is performed using the for clause. To see our substring function in action, I'm using the literal string Poland Springs for my string expression argument, the number 2 for my from argument, and then the number 5 for my for argument. The result is Oland, or O-L-A-N-D. Since I asked to start in the second position, the O in Poland Springs is the second character for our starting position. Then from there, I asked for a length of 5 characters, so counting 5 from the second character, I end up with Oland. Let's try another example. I am using the same literal expression, but this time I am starting in position 8 and requesting a length of 6 characters to be returned. The 8th character in Poland Springs is the first S in Springs, and 6 characters from that starting position results in returning the word spring. The length argument is optional. In my next example, I am omitting the length argument, which results in the remaining characters of the string being returned starting with the 3rd position. In this video, I explained how to use the substring function to receive a set number of characters from a string. The string and starting position are required arguments for the function, while the length argument is optional. You can find more information on the substring function on the online Teradata documentation site.